Hello, and welcome to the next Innovation Coffee Break. My name is Kevin, and I am software developer for dSPACE SystemDesk. Today, I want to introduce a new feature in the SystemDesk V-ECU environment, the possibility to create V-ECUs based on the FMI standard. First of all, I want to recap some basics of virtual electronic control units, so-called V-ECUs. You can use the V-ECUs to forward realistic tests to software-in-the-loop testing, which can take place parallel to the development phases of an ECU. V-ECUs can be classified in three different levels. The level 1 V-ECU are based on application software and comes with the basic software generated by SystemDesk. The level 2 V-ECUs have a combination of basic software from the real ECU and generated ZIL basic software from SystemDesk, in addition to the application software. The level 3 V-ECUs are the most realistic and complex virtual replicates of the ECU, in which the software under test is directly based on the microcontroller abstraction layer and can integrate the full application and basic software of the real target. The higher the level, the more realistic the simulation, and therefore, the more complex test scenarios are possible. For example, to create simulation systems with REST bus containers, environment models, or connected VECUs. All VECU levels can be used for ZIL testing with dSPACE tools, and SystemDesk provides various functionalities to adapt VECUs to the needs of the customer. Furthermore, we have enabled our customer to benefit from the advantages of VECUs in several cases. With the new SystemDesk FMU export feature, it is possible to create VECUs based on the functional mockup interface FMI standard. The VECU export as FMU is now available for all three VECU levels. This will open up new opportunities for our customers to collaborate with their business partners and make the exchange of VECUs much simpler than before. Now, we'll have a deeper look into the VECU. Typically, current ECU architectures are based on the AUTOSAR standard and consist of three main parts: application software, RTE, and basic software. But no worries, our VECU approach does not necessarily need an AUTOSAR architecture and works for non-AUTOSAR ECU as well. The software under test makes up the upper layer, and the lower layer of the VECU consists of the SystemDesk in both cases. The lowest layer of a VECU with AUTOSAR architecture is a microcontroller abstraction layer, which is directly connected to the dSPACE-specific simulator abstraction layer inside the VECU. To export the VECU as an FMU, the simulator abstraction layer must be decoupled from the platform. That's why we have implemented an independent AUTOSAR operating system and a simulator abstraction layer based on the functional mockup interface. To support the FMI standard, the lowest layer of the VECU must implement the functional mockup interface. Since there are no proprietary interfaces, there are no further dependencies to the simulation software. The VECU is now 100% compatible with the FMI standard and can be exported as a VECU FMU and can be executed with any FMI-compatible simulator. Whereas there are no changes to the layer above the simulation abstraction, the process and interfaces for the customer code stays the same, and the architecture isn't affected by the format changes. The customer does not need FMI-specific knowledge to create a VECU FMU, and both container formats can be executed on VEOS. That's enough for the theoretical part. Now I want to show you the FMU export directly in SystemDesk. In this demonstration, I want to show you how easy an VECU can be created and can be exported as VECU FMU. For the start, I have already opened a demonstration project of SystemDesk, the V-ECUs demonstration project. To create an FMU, you have, first of all, to create an ECU configuration in the ECU configuration manager, what you can do with this button here. The open up dialog gives you options to create default configurations for VECUs and FMUs. In this case, we need a default ECU configuration for VECU FMUs with CAN driver, because we have two VECUs communicated with CAN network. In preparation of this demo, I have already created and generated the modules for the FMU. The next step is to use this ECU configuration to create a VECU in the VECU manager. The open up dialog here, you can choose the ECU configuration in the bottom. Now you can see I've already created in VECU, including all application software components, basic software, and RTE, as well as the FMI standard implementation here. The last step of creating an FMU is to export it in the RIMS. Here you can choose a directory where you want to export it, and you can select the platform, for example, Windows 64 and the GCC compiler. Like you can see, we have already executed the VECU FMU and successfully created it. In controllers, I have already created an experiment with our offline simulation application from VEOS. Like you can see here in my layout, there are a plotter for the input signals of the controller VECU and a plotter for the inputs of the engine model. Every signal I want to measure is already mapped on this plotter. To start the measuring, I only need to start it in the ribbon. The signal flow you can see here is a calculation of the fuel rate of the engine model and its output of the controller. So now you have seen how a VECU FMU can be created with SystemDesk and how it is executed on VEOS. The workflow for FMUs is quite similar to the VECU creation workflow. In addition to that, we have seen a small example plot of our fuel system demo with FMUs, which has shown the signal flow of inputs and outputs. Let's put theory and demonstration together. The VECU FMU exported by SystemDesk implements the interface of the FMI standard. Every functionality of the VECU FMU is based on this interface, and therefore it can achieve maximum portability and platform independency. But the FMI standard isn't as extensive as a proprietary dSPACE simulator interface for VECUs. To improve the FMI standard and to cover more use cases of VECUs, dSPACE collaborates in the FMI standardization board. We work intensively on layered standards for XCP and automotive bus simulation to make FMUs as realistic and accurate as dSPACE VECUs. Because of the limited time in this video format, I can't explain every detail of my demonstration. If you have any questions about this video, don't hesitate to contact us. My colleagues and I will be happy to answer any question in more detail. Thank you very much for your attention, and we look forward to being your partner in simulation and validation.